It's Wednesday on Good Day Orlando, and we are on reptile watch today. This week, it's all about the eastern indigo snake. Joining us this morning from the Central Florida Zoo, our good friend Stephanie Kettle is here. Good to see
Hello.
You. Welcome
Here's
back.
Is Amy drifting this way?
Originally, we were standing like this, and then I was like, you know what, Ryan? Why don't you just move into the middle?
Let me tell you, this snake's actually really cool because you have nothing to worry about with these guys. They're non-venomous, and they actually can eat venomous snakes. So they're actually immune to venom. So they actually do eat our native venomous snakes. He is a native animal, but they are a protected species. And
he's got an awesome color.
He does. So eastern indigo snake comes from that shiny black color that he has. They're actually, their stomachs kind of are that indigo bluish color.
That's beautiful.
And that's the best way to know the difference between them and a black racer. Black racers are not going to be so shiny, and they're going to have a white chin. These guys have black chins.
And the black racer is very common around here. Those are the ones that I see those on my back porch all the time, right? But this you wouldn't see as often.
You would not see this as often. This is a threatened species because their numbers are not doing so well. So they are found in very specific areas, dry, sandy habitats. They like to go into burrows. So they are in areas that we usually like to develop. So they're suffering from habitat loss.
And we hear these stories. People just have a fear of snakes in some cases. And you always hear they're good snakes. This is a great example.
This is a great example. So they eat a lot of rodents and they also help control venomous snake populations.
Very camera friendly too.
He is. They're actually very curious. Eastern indigo snakes actually have really good eyesight for a snake. That's why they got those big eyes. So she's actually really good at seeing. Also using the tongue to sense around them. But most snakes have bad eyesight. They actually have pretty good eyesight for a snake.
I love it. Crazy. And you guys do a really cool thing. I just want to let folks know, if you haven't been at the Central Florida Zoo in a while, you have an area right outside of where the snake habitat is.
Yeah.
And you guys bring the snakes out and you do educational talks, right?
Exactly. So do that every day at noon. It's called our Venom Show. You can learn about venomous snakes from around the world, native snakes, and then sometimes we do other meet and greets throughout the zoo with a species like this.
It's like a pretzel now.
Yeah.
What happens?
Just getting cuddly.
Oh my gosh, I love it. This is wild.
Do you want to pet
Wild
me?
Wednesday.
Come on.
It really, her skin is
You fed
beautiful.
A snake at the Central Florida Zoo.
Yes,
so
I did. Stephanie's great. She brought us all behind the scenes, and we had a great time that day. So we're very familiar. We're very familiar with them.
Well, thank you so much,
Stephanie.
You're welcome.
Go visit the zoo.
Absolutely.
They're just doing such great things over there.
Thanks
so much for being with us.
Thank you.
All right, let's talk to Jim.